In this video, I'll briefly introduce EMPO, which is a modeling tool for operations research problems. Then I'll show you how to download and install it on your own computer. EMPO has many features and options. This series of tutorial videos cover only a small subset of them. If you are interested in learning more about EMPO, you can download the book titled EMPO, A Modeling Language for Mathematical Programming, 2nd edition, which is usually referred to as the EMPO book. This book is available from this website for free, EMPO.com Resources, the EMPO book. EMPO is an acronym for a mathematical programming language. It is an algebraic modeling language for describing highly complex problems for large-scale mathematical computation. It was originally developed by Robert Forer, David Gay, and Brian Kanigan at Bell Labs. According to the news statistics, EMPO is the most popular language for representing mathematical programming problems. In the past 3 years, 2014 to 2016, a total of 2.8 million problems were submitted to the news server. 1.7 million of them were modeled in EMPO, and 0.8 million of them were modeled in GAMS, the second most popular modeling tool. I'll talk more about the new server in another video. EMPO is just a modeling language. It translates the problem into a mathematical model and then relies on external solvers to actually solve the formulated model. EMPO supports both open source and commercial solvers. These linear models mainly handle linear and convex quadratic optimization problems with both continuous and integer variables. These nonlinear solvers are effective in handling and finding locally optimal solutions to problems involving smooth, nonlinear functions using a variety of proven algorithms. EMPO offers four types of licenses for different purposes. EMPO for Business targets large-scale business optimization applications in manufacturing, transportation, energy, finance, and many other sectors. The license needs to be paid at full price. EMPO for Research targets researchers in universities and corporate labs to solve a diverse range of problems in all fields of engineering as well as some sciences. The license comes with a highly discounted price. EMPO for Teaching is meant for classroom use, go along with a scheduled course throughout a semester. It is completely free and comes with full-featured commercial servers and no restriction on problem sizes. Professors submit a request for the course, then they will receive a special version of the software. They can freely distribute it to the students so they can install on their own computers. The students can use it for the duration of the course. It will stop working after the course ends. EMPO for Students is a free demo version that is aimed to help students quickly get familiar with formulating and solving small-scale optimization models. There are some problem size restrictions. For linear programming problems, it is limited to 500 variables and constraints. For nonlinear programming problems, it is limited to 300 variables and constraints. We can also use the new server, which contains many free online solvers. The limitation is that the problems submitted will be put in a queue. If the server is busy, it may take a while before your problem is processed. I have previously used the EMPO for Teaching version in my class and distributed it to my students. Later, I found out that the free EMPO for Students version was adequate for illustrative purposes when teaching students the basic concepts of operations research, because we were only dealing with small-scale problems in the course. Therefore, I'll talk about how to download and install this EMPO for Students version. For a Windows computer, you need to go to this website, EMPO.com. Enter the menu Products. EMPO, select for students. Then click Demo version. Download a free demo. Alternatively, you can directly go to this website, EMPO.com, try EMPO, download a free demo. Now click Windows and download this compressed ample.ide.mswin64.zip file. It is about 160 megabytes. The installation is really easy. You just need to unzip the file to extract the folder named ample.ide.mswin64. You may rename it and move it to another location on your computer. To run ample.ide, you need to get inside the folder. Double-click to open the ample.ide folder, and then double-click the ample.ide.exe file. It will bring you to the ample.ide window. For a Mac computer, the only difference is the last step. You need to go to the website ample.com. Enter the menu Products, Ample, select for Students. Then click Demo version, download a free demo. You can also directly go to this website, ample.com, try Ample, download a free demo. Click Mac OS instead of Windows, and download this compressed ample.ide.macOS64.tgz file. To install, you just need to double-click the .tgz file to extract the folder named ample.ide.macOS64. You may rename it and move it to another location on your computer. To run ample.ide, you need to get inside the folder, then double-click to open the ample.ide file. If there is an error that says ample.ide cannot be opened because it is from an unidentified developer, you can press Ctrl and click the file, and then choose Open to start the ample.ide. Okay, that's a brief introduction of Ample and how to download and install it on your computer. Thanks for watching.